In this video, we're going to install some of the best free templates for WordPress's Gutenberg. The reason I like this method is because you get to choose which pages you install out of the templates, but they have certain themes that are available to choose from. All of these home pages have an accompanying subpages to them, so you can click it, browse the home page that you could install, install an about page that goes with it. So after we install the template, I'm going to show you how to adjust the fonts and colors for the theme as well. This tutorial assumes you have WordPress installed. If you don't, there's a link in the description on how to install WordPress. So to get started, I'm going to put in a theme that has a transparent header just in case you want that transparent header with your template. So I go to Appearance, Themes, Add New, Astra, and then we go ahead and install and activate Astra. It's free and it's made by the same people that make the templates, so that's one of the reasons why I choose it, so it cooperates. Once you have the Astra theme, go ahead and put in the plugin, Plugins, Add New, search for Spectra. Go ahead and install and activate this plugin. Once you have that active, you can get started by putting in the template, Pages, Add New. We'll start with the home page. Since I have the Astra theme, I'm just gonna make the title disappear and then click this Spectra Template Kits button at the top. If this doesn't load right away, just give it a minute and then refresh the page. Sometimes their server gets overloaded, but here's the one I want. Click the home. To preview the site, there's a button at the bottom. If you click that, it takes you to the demo. And this is where I can inspect the font. I'll show you how to do that in a minute. But let's say I just want to put in the home. Go ahead and import the home. And you see we got a good start. So one of the issues with this is that you might not understand how it works. So you click the list view at the top, and you can get the layout on how each container is laid out for your home page. You can see this container has flex properties going left to right for these two containers, whereas this container has a flex property that goes vertically so that the blocks within it go vertical. That's kind of how these are laid out. So now you can understand how they're laid out if you ever need to copy it. All right, so we got our home page. You'll see, we'll do it one more time with an about page. So let's go back to the dashboard and then we'll do the fonts and colors. So pages, add new, about, template kit. Okay, find the about page, import that. Oh, and I'll also put in a blog page as well. So publish that, and then I'm going to set the home page as the home page, so I'll show you how to do that. So now we got the about page. Still need to adjust the fonts and the colors, but we'll do that. One more page, the blog page, add new. And this one you don't use a template for, so you just call it blog and it's just an empty page. Okay, so now we got our blog page. Now I need to tell WordPress that this home page, set it to home. So go Appearance, Customize. And if you're running the Astra theme, behind my camera, there is a settings called Home Page Settings. And this is where you choose a static page. Home page, select home, and the blog page now. This is why I made the blog page. Tell WordPress to stick all your posts in blog. Publish that. And now we have our home page set up. If we go to our visit site. You can see it's not running the transparent header. I'll show you how to do that too. But we have a good start. Now, how do we get the fonts to what we want? So we'll go back to the customizer, go to dashboard, appearance, customize. And we need to adjust the fonts, and we do that from the global settings, typography. Here are the ready-made pairs that come with Astra. So you could pick one of these, or you can set them yourself down here. If I want to duplicate the exact theme that I was browsing, remember when I was within the plugin and I was browsing the actual demo, if I want to use this one that they used, I would just right click inspect, use this little arrow here on the side and hover over it, and you see it's railway. It's probably a railway bold, and the paragraph font is Open Sans. So I would go back to my customizer, headings font, railway. And I think it was kind of a bold. You might not be able to see it. Let me scroll down. Make it a little bit more bold. Maybe it was semi. No, I think it was bold. All right, so you can play around with that. And we need to do this one as Open Sans. So we'll go body font was Open Sans. Okay. So that's how you would copy their template. Publish that. Now, a lot of these templates pull the color scheme from your global colors. So if you put in a template and the color looks strange, it's because your colors under your global settings haven't been set yet. So go to global from the customizer, global colors, and adjust the colors here. And then once you change your accent color to what you want, you might see your template change, because a lot of the templates will pull this accent color from this global palette here. So if I adjust color 2 to, you know, something totally different, it's going to convert it within, because a lot of these templates will pull. Doesn't look like it's pulling that, but you can see the accent color is up here and that's pulling from it. And the button is using it as well. You could adjust it here. So yeah, that's the fonts, that's the colors. Oh, to get the transparent header, just for that page, I'll show you how to do it individually. Go to the page. Oops. I gotta view all my pages, edit. So to set it for this individual homepage, you'd hit this Astra icon at the top. Advanced settings. Enable transparent header. That'll give you a transparent header for this exact page. You could set each one yourself, because some of them have transparent header and some you don't want. So as just an easy way to do it is just to individually pick, if it's a simple site, just to pick the ones that do. And that'll get you your transparent header. In the next video, I'm actually going to do like a transparent header tutorial where I go through all the settings in the customizer, but that's just a preview. So that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, let the algorithm know.